What is the number one thing that people say is key for relationships? You knew that answer already. How to keep things fresh, fun, exciting, enjoyable, and not dull and boring. In today's video, we're gonna talk about several things that I think are important to keep in mind when you're in a relationship, marriage, partnership. I think they are things that we know, but we may kind of forget about over time, and this is where I'm here to remind you about them so that you can keep these top of mind and nurture your relationship. No one wants to get into a position where they're like, oh, I'm kind of bored or not excited or not as happy or whatnot. But how are you gonna manage that? How are you gonna keep that fun? As humans, we like variety. We like to be spontaneous. We like change. We like, oh, that's a new flavor. But before we get into the video, I would love to know, have you subscribed to my channel yet? If not, I'll give you a few seconds to do that now. The button is right below this video. Yeah, that red button, good. Now that that's done, let's get into the video. The order I'm gonna say these in is not order of importance, it is just how I'm thinking of them. So the first thing I'm gonna say is, what do we love so much about just starting to date somebody? We like that it is new, it is territory we have not been in yet, we have not explored this. Opening the levels of our brain that are like, ooh, I have never been here before and I like what I'm seeing and this is so exciting and so fun. It's all new. So my first tip that I think is quite important that I think gets put on the back burner a lot is trying new things with your partner. People love the newness of a relationship. Like there's an episode of Friends where it's like, I think it's when Monica's getting married. She's like, wow, I'll never date again. Like that newness. And she said the word new. So trying new things is key. And it doesn't have to be like you're going skydiving or some bungee jumping every weekend trying to do something different. It could be as simple as trying a new restaurant or doing a workout together if you normally work out separately, or cooking something you've never cooked before yet, or going somewhere you've never gone to yet. So just doing one new thing a month even would probably do wonders for your relationship. Number two, date night. I know date night, the term has been used a lot, you probably heard it a lot, but it is actually so important. A lot of people think you're going on a date when you're like starting to date somebody, but a lot of people forget that we should be continuously for the rest of our lives dating our partners. Quality time should happen like frequently throughout the week or the month or whatnot, but date night should be maybe like one night that it's a little bit more extra, it's a little bit different. It's a night you get a little bit dolled up, it's a night you go out, you know, put a cute outfit on, you stay in, put a cute outfit on. Like it doesn't have to be crazy. Whatever date night is for you, it should be a little bit different than your quality time night so that it feels like a date. Think about when you get ready for a date, when you're single or you're starting to date somebody, how exciting that is and how fun that is. We should be carrying that out through our relationships. So now let's head over to quality time. Like I said, quality time should be had frequently throughout the week. And again, remember, it's not quantity of time, it's quality of time. In my personal definition, quality time is no phones, eye contact, communicating, like being present with each other. That could be for an hour, that could be for 4 hours. I'm very flexible with my quality time. So whatever quality time means for you, do that. Life gets busy, life gets in the way. You know, you're tired, you're working a lot, your partner may be working a lot. Things happen and you could almost, if you're not conscious about quality time, just end up like feeling like roommates, or like if you've been married for a while, like you just feel like, oh, I live with this person, but I like, what do we do together? Or, you know, when do we spend real time together? If you have kids, probably even harder. And I'm trying to remember that now so that I could like be aware of that now, so that when I do have kids, you know, these things are really top of mind. So that brings me into my next tip, which is love languages. I'll link my video on love languages right here where I go really into depth about them, but I'm saying this one next because quality time is one of the 5 love languages. And if quality time is super important for me, but it's not for my partner, I may have an issue. Having your partner understand yours, you understand your partner's, will definitely help with what makes you feel most connected to that person. If quality time is super important for both of you, you'll probably have an easier time achieving that. The point is, learn your partner's love languages, the ones that are most important, learn yours. There's also, I find, a difference in what you like to give versus what you like to receive. I've noticed I love giving gifts to people. I love buying something, seeing something in a store, buying it for the person and knowing that, like, I'm gonna surprise them with this, and I love giving gifts. I don't need gifts. Receiving them, not important to me. I like receiving words of affirmation, touch, quality time. Those are like really, really big for me. Then probably acts of service, then gifts. Gifts is last, but I love giving it. All those things are important for how I am made up as Veronica, for how your partner is made up, and it's important to know. So love languages is basically, like, I like to think of it as a key into the person's brain, body, soul, so that you can be the best partner possible. I think what also is so attractive is people wanting to know their partner's love language or love languages, because that shows that they are emotionally available, emotionally aware, self-aware, and just like wanting to learn and grow. And I think that's one of the most attractive traits and qualities somebody can have. So just saying, if I think that, maybe other people think that and could win you some good brownie points. I know this may seem counterintuitive or weird that I'm saying this after talking about quality time and date nights and stuff like that, but couples also need time apart. So this tip is, spend time alone. Now that time is good for you. It is good for the relationship. It is good to bring, you know, distance makes the heart grow fonder, that whole saying. I'm not talking about long distance, because that's a whole other topic and that's really, really hard. But I'm talking about distance as in, have hobbies, have your girls' night, have your boys' nights, have your friends, have things you do without your partner that make you come back like, oh, I missed you, you know? I know we all go to work separately and then we come home, but that's like work. I'm talking about other things. I'm talking about things that will make you have your own lives. I think a partnership, even a marriage and everything, is two lives blending together, but you're also two individuals. Haven't you heard people say, like, I totally lost myself in that relationship, or I didn't even know who I was in that relationship? Those are things that we don't want. We want to have, you know, individuality within your partnership. So that's that. Okay, now this one is, I don't know what it's really called, but I'm calling it like gratitude, appreciation, and not taking things for granted. Let's say you're dating somebody for 2 years or you're married for 20 years. Going to dinner with your partner and having whoever pays for dinner pay for dinner could be something that long term you take for granted. And the person paying may feel really, really appreciated and respected. Little things like thanking your partner when they make dinner for you both shows that you don't take it for granted. It doesn't go unnoticed. You appreciate it. You have gratitude for it. And that's so important. I think that it is like not talked about enough, and that's the whole point of this video, is to keep things fresh. If you start not doing the things you were doing when you first started dating the person, that's what like dilutes and doesn't keep things fresh. So basically act like you're still dating the person. This one is important. This one's very important. Effective, healthy communication. Communication can be very, very hard because some people have not been taught how to communicate. Some people have been taught very poorly how to communicate just by their upbringing and what they've modeled from what they've seen, but some people haven't been taught at all, so they don't even know how. So when you're trying to meld two people together and one person is a really healthy communicator, let's say, and one person doesn't communicate at all, or you have two really unhealthy ways of communicating, like, we need to get a handle on that. So effective, healthy communication. You gotta look up, you gotta read some books on communicating. You gotta find ways that are healthy for you to communicate. You gotta get some tips and tricks on that, because what is the number one thing that people say is key for relationships? Communication. You knew that answer already. But do we practice enough healthy communication, or do we just get by? If there's an issue and something's been, you know, triggered in you and you were pissed about it, but you held it in and you were like cold for a little bit, but then a few hours later you saw the person again and it kind of just like drifted away and then you warmed up to the person again, that's not healthy communication. You just basically bottled that in and then pushed it down and then buried it and tried to get past it. That's not communicating. And that problem is going to come up later again. Another thing that is very important is intimacy. I'm not gonna get too crazy with this topic, but when I say intimacy, if you are a guy watching, you probably thought of sex immediately, right? If you are a woman watching, I bet you the act of sex wasn't the only thing you thought of. For women, intimacy means, you know, having a emotional and intimate conversation. Intimacy could be hugging and kissing. Intimacy could be holding hands. When women have sex, they release a hormone called oxytocin, and that is released during sex. It's also released during breastfeeding, and it's basically the hormone of having a strong bonded connection. That's why sex is a lot more important for women than it is for men, because they feel bonded to that person. That is why sex is also very important for women in a relationship, because they want to continue feeling that bond. Guys can feel that bond during sex, during other things, but women, you know, that's just the difference between sex for men and women. Intimacy, if you think about your first date with somebody, I'm sure you guys were intimate without having sex. There were things that built up to eventually getting there, but that is called intimacy. You don't just go like from 0 to 100, it builds up. Remembering that there is a fun feeling with, you know, dating a person, and then if you're living with them now or married to them now or have kids with them now, remembering what it was like to date them and having those little moments of intimacy, and then, you know, of course sex, but all of that stuff combined, I just think it's very important to keep in mind. And the last thing I'm gonna say is, I know vacations aren't necessarily in everyone's budget, but I do think that they are important for a relationship. You don't want to be in your same bubble of life all the time, and I'm not saying you need to go on a 5-star resort vacation, but you can also do things like renting an Airbnb for the weekend in a different part of town, or, you know, doing a staycation at a hotel in a different part of town, or going somewhere that is a few hours away, or taking a road trip or a short flight somewhere, doing something that is lifting you up, plucking you out of your everyday life and dropping you somewhere else. Like, it's spontaneous, it's different, it is romantic, forgetting all of what you've got going on at home. It is something that I think definitely helps the spark and keep things fresh. And, you know, who doesn't love a vacation or a staycation? But I love that idea. I hope you learned something new in this video. I hope you can apply it into your relationships with your partner, and I would love to know what you think in the comments below. So tell me if you have any other relationship tips, anything to keep things fresh and fun, hit me up in the comments. I would love to read them. Don't forget to hit that like button if you like this type of content, and subscribe to the channel and hit the bell so that you get notified every time I post a new video. You will be in the loop and you'll see it pop up. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.